In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use Midjourney to make mockups for your print on demand products. Hi guys, my name is RJ Martinez. I've been doing print on demand for over 6 years now, and I have made over $1 million in sales all time. All right, so I'm over here in the back end of Midjourney and typed in mockup for a plain black t-shirt on a wood floor. So this right here, depending on what it is, so mockup for a plain black t-shirt, you can switch this to white t-shirt, red t-shirt, green t-shirt, whatever color t-shirt that you would want to, you know, put a design on. And then I just mess with this, and this all depends on the theme too. So on a wood floor, and it gets you to think. Now there's different scenarios, there's different scenes, this all depends, right? So think about like a different holidays coming up. That would be a good idea. Or just the theme of your website, the theme of your Etsy shop, or your Etsy store. There's different things that you can put right here. Let's say like you want like a cloud background, a cloudy blue sky background or something like that. You don't want the wood floor, right? You can do that. Now, I did it right here on the white one too as well. Mock-up for a plain white t-shirt hanging on a wall. Same thing here. So just different kind of, you know, it's almost like this one doesn't have a hanger. This one does, right? So just think about it, like how you're talking to it and how you're going to describe what you want and what type of mock-up you want. At the end of the day, you can even do this for all holidays. Keep that in mind. So you can do like Christmas, Thanksgiving, 4th of July, whatever it is, you know, and the way that you want to do it. This is what I recommend, you know, how you would talk to a mock-up for a plain white t-shirt. So hanging on a wall with a, you know, 4th of July theme background or a Thanksgiving theme background. Now, any of these two as well, just keep in mind you can, you know, upscale any of these images here. If you like a certain one, you can do a different variation. If you like number one, you want to do a variation of that one. You like that, you know, the idea and how it looks, the theme of it, you can do a different variation of that one. I'm going to show you this in this video, so make sure you stay to the very end of this. Same thing with this one too as well. So you can see how I did that. Very simple, very easy. So I did some themed mockups. So here's the 4th of July one. You can see what it did here. It's kind of getting the concept, getting the idea. I think it's maybe just do for set of 4th of July, I maybe would do just American flag theme background. Kind of get the idea. Now, when it comes to doing research for print on demand, my go-to tool is Merchant Informer. I'm going to have my affiliate link down below in the description, so check that out.
Of, you know, whatever the holiday is and what people are really passionate about. So, and you're seeing like a lot of, you know, American flags for 4th of July, stuff like that, or even just like a barbecue cookout stuff, you know, a barbecue theme background, something like that would be really good too, I think, with, you know, a theme of 4th of July. And then we come down Thanksgiving. Now, Thanksgiving themed background, you see what I did here. And it's kind of, it did a pretty good job with this one, right? There's certain ones, and some of them, they even put a design on the actual t-shirt itself. Now we look at the background, they're pretty good, right? Kind of, you know, it gets the theme, the style of Thanksgiving, right? So if we go down and we got Christmas. Now, I think it was like getting the concept, like this one's pretty decent. I like this one, right? But I think if anything that you're trying to do, if there's like a certain theme that you want, if you want more pine cones, you know, say I want more pine cones, you know, in this mock-up, or put more pine cones in the mock-up, right? So think about it that way, or you want like a Christmas gifts in the background. Think about it like that. When you're creating the prompt, make sure you include it in there. And this will help you, you know, generate what you're looking for. Same thing here, mock-up plain black t-shirt, Easter themed background. We look, right? There's some orange eggs. Say if you want like a certain color egg, more of that certain color egg. Or if you want a Easter bunny in the background or something like that, you can do that too as well. So you can see the idea here, right? And then creating different themed mock-ups, or even just coming over here and just creating a simple mock-up, something like a white or a black. All right, so I went ahead and took the black plain mock-up t-shirt with the wood background right here. You can see the prompt that I typed in, right? And I upscaled it, the variation 2 right there. So it went ahead and, you know, brought us up the variation 2. I went ahead, right click and you just save the image, right? Just come over here to a photo P, and we're gonna come over here to new project. And then the width we're gonna do is 27 for 2025 DPI. It's all up to you, but I'll leave it at 72 DPI. And then the background, I'm gonna go ahead and change it to transparent. And then I'm gonna go ahead and hit create. And that right there is basically the listing size requirements for, you know, Etsy. So they require a minimum of a 72 DPI resolution at least, right? Now, if we come over here, I'm gonna go ahead and grab an image. I'm gonna grab that mockup. Let me bring this over here. I'm gonna grab that mockup. drag and drop the image over here. And then as I drag and drop that image, I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, scale it out, bring it closer to the sides, boom. And remember to, like, if you don't like doing these, you know, these type of scaled out images like that, you can also come over to grab this one over here and bring it over here so you can see full pixel cut, and you can go ahead and upload an image over here. And I explained this information right here in the video up in the card up here. You check that out, the step-by-step process on how to upscale any image. And this is an AI image, right? So we can upscale this image right here and make it like more of a higher quality image, so you can do the little stretchies and stuff, a little stretch and however you want. If you're not a big fan of, you know, stretching out an image, you want to upscale it, you can definitely do that over here with pixel cut, and it's free. Now we're going to go ahead and add a design to this so we can get this bad boy rocking. All right, so now we're with the mock-up. And we have it, it's good like that, and we're happy with it. And what we're gonna do is just resize this to this. And you can do this with all your designs if you like, right? Click on, and click on that, move that, yeah. Making sure we got this as best as possible and straight as possible on here. And also, if you're looking at this, you can see, like, I'm just clicking the images, clicking them, I'm highlighting them and moving them around as best as I see fit. Now that right there seems, and you can also too keep in mind, you can stretch in any of these images out, kind of just enlarge them, make them a little bit bigger, so you know you're a little bit happier with where the placement of this actual design is. And it's all about, you know, getting it to that right placement to how you want it, right? And boom. And then depending on how you want to save it or export it as, let's say JPEG, and we go ahead and we're gonna save it as a JPEG, and we're gonna hit save, and then we'll come over here and enlarge the image, and boom. Crazy, huh? Really cool, real awesome. And you know, that's as, you know, how you create a mock-up for your Etsy shop or your own personal website, or even if you're running some type of ads to a certain design. Boom, right there is how you would create a mock-up using, this is all UBI using AI too, by the way. The design is AI, the mock-up is AI. Dude, this is a crazy time that we live in, right? It's amazing. So,
and if you want to learn how to upscale your AI images, please watch this video right here next.